Hi everyone, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to see how to solve this error. I wanted to log into my SQL PHP my admin and log into my SQL. Then I got a message which says MySQLi real connect HY00/2002no such file on the directory. So I was a little bit confused and I started thinking that maybe something went wrong. I went to php.ini and I tried to fix up some stuff, but there's nothing I was supposed to fix anyway. But I also went to Google and tried to search for that error, but now I got different what responses and which could not help me. You never know the reference, the problems you can fix, you can get from Google might be one of them, like might be the real answer to you. But mine also could also maybe help you somehow. Maybe we might be facing the same cause. If it's the same cause, it should be the same what fix. But if it's not, then it's not. So they say my SQL connection driver does not get any meaningful server at the location of host. So use it's advisable to use this. Some people say we use this, use that. Okay, we use 127. Yeah, it's gonna be 127.0.0.1. Then you say enter. When we enter Apache starting, then / php my admin. Okay, we enter that. Once we enter that, it's gonna say put in the username, put in the password, then we enter. We still get this error even if we visit using this. So that could also help you, because it said rather instead of using localhost, because here it has to be localhost, so we replace it with 127.0.0.1, this localhost, and it works for some people. This is one of the first solution. Instead of using that, they say replace that, remove that, and say 127.0.0.1. Then you hit your enter. Then, but me, in my case, this does not work. I'm testing for the second time, you can see. So if I say login, it doesn't work. So I'm gonna show you what's the problem in my case. So I'm using Cal Linux. I don't know which operating system you're using. That could be that could be also a difference. So the thing is, we're going to solve this, but in a different way. But try firstly use what I've showed you now to see if that can work for you. Also, you have to check your port. If the port is not 3306, all those are alternative to check, because that is the default port. You get me? So if it doesn't use the default port, it simply means you have to get the port they have given you. Maybe the port was changed, set to something else. So if the port was changed to something else, then you should also do what? Use a different port. Let me see something.
That's not the way we put in the port. Let me see. No, that's port number was not okay, guys. Now let's say localhost
php my admin. Okay, no, that's not what I'm looking for. Localhost php my admin, I'm looking for this. Okay, I'm putting in the username, password. Give me the prompt. Okay, let's solve the prompt. If you're using Kali Linux or any kind of Linux, this is the error we're talking about, the error down here. So not this one, but the error down here. So what we say is go to your terminal if you are using Linux, and try to be sudo. Then you say Apache, you say service Apache 2 start. Okay, you start Apache. Wow, this is crazy. It's gonna be service. Has to be like this to start. Then service. Wow. Let me. I'm making mistakes here. Start. Okay, that's fine. Then you have to start your MySQL start. Yeah, once that is done, then you can close your terminal, close this, then go back to your browser, and you can type in this 127.0.0.1. That's not the solution in this, in my case, but it could be the solution to your case. But I'll tell you what's the solution, and now it's working. I'm 100% sure. Then you're gonna go and say, we're looking for what it's gonna be PHP my admin. So once you're there, you're gonna see this interface. On this interface, what you're gonna do, type in your username, then type in your password. Then after that, you start. Yeah, you can see now that everything is working. So when I click here, I can see this database is here, and there's nothing which is not working. Everything is working. So the reason why we're getting that problem is, one, I can show you, then we can also make it to happen again, and we fix it again. So the reason was service MySQL stop. So service MySQL stop was stopped then when you're trying to log in the server. It says no file found on that. Let's try to see. You can see it takes you back and gives you this. So, but then once you decide to go and start the services, you're not going to see this error. So let me put a screen which is gonna help us to work together and see each side of the screen. So I guess you see this side. I'm gonna say again service MySQL start. Once I start those services, everything is gonna be fine. So I'm done. So I'm gonna refresh here. That message should go. So if I want to log in, you can see I can log in without any stress. You get me? So the reason why you're getting this problem in my case, it's like the services for MySQL were not started. So if you're using Windows, try to run your WAMP server. And if you're using XAMPP, also go to XAMPP and start those services. So if you're using other also operating systems, you have to know that those services are down. So check also on the port if the port for MySQL is still 3306. But if they change it, tell somebody who changed it to, or who's responsible, to give you a new port. Or alternatively, use 127.0.0.1 instead of using localhost. So three of those solutions might fix your problem. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe.